Hi, welcome to another lecture on spirochetes. Today I am going to discuss about Treponema, its subspecies, morphology, staining and culture, reactions to physical and chemical agents, characteristic movement under microscope. The genus Treponema includes Treponema pallidum, subspecies pallidum, which causes syphilis. Treponema pallidum, subspecies partinu, which causes yaws. Treponema pallidum, subspecies endemicum, which causes endemic syphilis, also called basal. Treponema keratinum causes pinta. The details on these diseases are not important. You just have to remember the disease names and the organism responsible for it. Now, let us analyze the morphology of Treponema pallidum. They are spiral, slender and thin-walled bacteria. The length is about 5 to 15 micrometer and breadth is about 0.2 micrometer. To give you some context about the size of Treponema pallidum, the average diameter of a red blood cell is 6 to 8 micrometer. The spiral coils of Treponema pallidum are regularly spaced at a distance at 1 micrometer from one another. They have double membrane, one outside the thin peptidoglycan layer, another inside the cell wall. The periplasmic space contains special filament like flagella called the endoflagella. Together they are called axial filament. As the cell wall is thin, they can't be stained with drum staining. They can be seen by using special techniques like immunofluorescence stain, dark field illumination and silver impregnation method. Pathogenic Treponema pallidum has never been cultured continuously in an artificial media. This is a violation of Koch's postulate. This is a frequently asked question in the oral examination, so imprint this properly in your memory. The organisms are actively motile. They show rotatory and forward movement like corkscrew around their endoflagella. This movement can be seen by ordinary microscopy only through dark ground illumination, but it can't be seen under immunofluorescence microscopy as the spirochete is already dead. Treponema is extremely fastidious and fragile. Drying kills the spirochete rapidly, as does elevation of temperature to 42 degrees Celsius. Treponema are rapidly immobilized and killed by trivalent arsenics, mercury and bismuths. Historically, these drugs were used in the treatment of syphilis. Treponema pallidum grows very slowly in the body. This is important because antibiotic must be present at the effective level for several weeks to kill the organism and to cure the disease. To kill Treponema pallidum, a single injection of benzathine penicillin G 2.4 million units is used because penicillin is released very slowly from the depot preparation, thus it maintains bactericidal concentration for weeks. To put it in a nutshell, Treponema pallidum causes syphilis. They are spiral thin-walled bacteria. They are motile as they have endoflagella. They cannot be stained by normal stains or cultured in normal media. And Treponema pallidum, they are treated by long-acting penicillin. Thank you for watching. If you like this presentation, please give us a thumbs up, comment below, and subscribe to our channel. Feel free to share this with your peers. That is all for today. See you in the next video. Thank you all.